My Little Pony, My Little Pony.
Every time I think I smell that sweet southern rain, it takes me to a station on the long black train. I wanna hear the wind blow and feel the earth move below me. In spite of all the good times, I gotta rest my soul. So I'm gone. I'm gone, gone to Carolina, where I know that I belong. Yes, I'm gone, yes, I'm gone, gone to Carolina, where I know I have a
I give up! Help! They're after me!
Stop! We're under arrest!
In the name of the law!
Mama! Mama! Please stop!
To do this, guys?
We're trying, but he's going unusually fast. To be precise, he is going unusually fast.
You're right. We've got to... Wait a minute. Is he using his magic to boost his speed? I'm opening your regulator as fast as possible, and we are really getting very much more on him than we thought.
Oh, I'm thirsty.
Damn it. We're almost a minute after, and you guys are completely out of water. Good thing there's a water tower here. Ah.
But it'll take time.
Damn it again. We've lost sight of him.
You thinking what I'm thinking, Doogie? To be precise, I certainly am. That Frenchman was no more a tourist than I'm a monster. He came to create trouble here.
Stop them! Stop them! Protect me!
Alonso, come out! That's an order!
No, I'd rather die by your hand.
I knew that man was off the pole.
For the last time, Alonso Di Pato, open the door up or I will blast the door down with a single spell! I promise, okay, now come out! Now have a drink and tell us what happened.
Well, I did exactly what Professor asked me to do.
You did you not? Did you act like a grumpy Frenchman?
Yes, Professor, exactly what I did. I tried to find various things as excuses to complain about, while at the same time remembering the ulterior motive of finding Johnson. But not only did I not find Johnson, I think I ended up in the wrong place and I got the wrong attention.
What do you mean, wrong place?
I mean the casino. For some reason, I thought Johnson lived nearby there, so I just headed to their in-house tea place, and I was disappointed that they didn't have Chinese tea, so I used that as an excuse to complain. Next thing I know, a few other colored horses come up to me and tell me to stop, and so I ran away.
Alonso! How much more stupid could you get?
I guess I've earned my promotion.
You?
You failed in your mission. Count yourself lucky that you haven't been exiled to Bottom Island. You both may go.
Their tea place doesn't sell Chinese tea. Now what if we sent someone over to help them make the tea better? Like a tea woman, for instance.
You don't have tea woman.
Yes, we have you.
Mervino be tea woman.
Of course, think about it, Mervino. You could teach them to brew some tea. You could poison them in the process. Then when they're not looking, you take your chance and steal one or two of their locomotives. Then you can go to the island to find Jacob Johnson. When you do, take him on the locomotives back here. Guess what? If you succeed in capturing Johnson, I'll give you a free trip to Tahiti.
Mervino think this good idea. Mervino start straight away.
Bravissimo, Mervino. And we'll also need to correct your speech a bit, for obvious reasons. No problem, we can do that by magic, for now. But remember, when in the land, whatever you do, do not use magic.
Thank you.
Okay, so here's the thing. We've been having a lot of disruptions on our railways lately, and at the weirdest times at that. We don't know what has been causing all of this, or why these humanoids have been coming here creating these disruptions. Are they really all that they seem?
I only wish I knew. The time and controller Fenton and I were knocked out by that monster alone.
You weren't knocked out, Tempest. You were eradicated. It's a good thing Koala came out just in time before you get eradicated beyond any means of revival.
All the same, you've got to be careful. Raven, as you know, is not here because he's guarding Appaloosa. From what he shared with us previously, it's quite likely that the monsters may or may not have some interest there, but we don't know what it is.
Hey, Soren, you here?
Yeah, is there anything?
Well, there's this biped woman who was asking to see you.
Another visitor?
Yes.
Soren, you go with Shining Armor first and take the visitor. If anything goes wrong, inform one of us immediately.
Will do.
You know what? This could be the moment. We'd better follow him secretly.
Good idea. Cigar, come with Mac and me.
Okay. That's the one. Yes, you've got wings. You can fly and speak with her. Okay. And how may we help you, ma'am?
My name is Jennifer Jameson, and I heard the tea shop was looking for a team. That's me. I'm a very experienced tea brewer.
Wow, you got that right, but you're not from these parts, are you? How come you knew about this?
Well, these things do go around quite fast, especially when it's something to do with these adorable ponies who I've loved since I was a little girl. You're Soren, am I right?
Excuse me, Miss Jennifer.
Can I possibly be speaking to Big Macintosh, the gentle giant of Sweet Apple Acres, always ready to pull a one-horse chain?
However did you guess?
You're looking for a tea woman, are you not? I'm on at any time.
Thing is, Miss Jennifer, we have no vacancies for tea women at the moment. However, considering that you are a very experienced brewer, we do have a vacancy for a cleaner in our engine sheds on all the railways. We need some pony to wash and polish our locomotives during the night shift so that they will be ready for the duties in the morning.
What?
Cigar, I think the tea woman's voice is breaking.
You're telling me. Every locomotive functions the same way as an average tea kettle. Since you're such an experienced tea brewer, I see no reason for you to have any issues cleaning up our locos.
I'm on it! Show me to the sheds!
Very well then, follow me, Miss Jennifer.
Mervyn all received trip to Tahiti.
Funny, I've got a feeling I've seen her face somewhere before.
Yeah, perhaps she might be more of a tea woman than the previous guy was a French epicure. We'll observe her discreetly.
Hello. Ah, yes, Margot, everything's going well here. Agent K's over at Mammoth Cave now. Operation Jacob Johnson will go as planned. Yes, correct. Send Sharon Miller to me.
Now, set to work, Miss Jennifer. The bucket and cloth are here for you, as is a detergent. If by tomorrow morning you have not finished polishing all of these locomotives here, you must die.
Who lived all over for Mervyn Hall? Now Mervyn Hall can feel great and Jacob Johnson in dead of night.
Well, Gorgeous, aren't you going to start cleaning us?
Don't you worry, I'll give you all a good scrubbing tonight. Here you go.
Ma'am, if you don't mind, not too hard. You're hurting me.
Psst. You thinking what I'm thinking, Dookie? To be precise, I shall nail that growl.
Two young people without a thing say some vows and spread their wings and settle down just what they need, living on love. She don't care about what's in style. She just likes the way he smiles. It takes more than marble and tile, living on love. Living on love, buying on time. Without somebody, nothing ain't worth a dime. Just like an old-fashioned storybook rhyme, living on love. It sounds simple, that's what you're thinking. But love can walk through fire without blinking. It doesn't take much when you
Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. Come visit my channel, subscribe me maybe.
You're watching Equestria TV, part of the BMS network.